Grab underneath the arm like that and pull it back like so. Then we can work the upper arm from this position. And you can lean it against the body if you want a little bit so it doesn't flop around so much. If you have an apron on, work down and up. Way down the front and up the back. And we can get down around the shoulders. Also work a little thumb work down this part of the arm, like so. And then you can also take it like this, straighten your arm out, holding your elbow so it doesn't flop down, holding under there, and then you can hold it under here and work down, like so. Down and finish with a little stroke. Okay, so the stretches are good. You can do before you oil the arm, it's a little easier. Take the arm out, give it a little rock, and lift up. I'm going to grab at the wrist. I'm bending down so I don't bend my back, and just lift up with my toes, stretch the arm up. And then put our arm back this way, give it a little stretch. You can lean, do some pressure point work down with the hands, down the upper arm. And come back here, stretch like this. And then you can also, coming over to the other side, or like so, and stretch like this. And here you can also grab here at our elbow and reach under. And I'm going to grab behind the shoulder blades and lift and stretch. That feel good? Mm-hmm. So, and then one last stretch. Okay. So here we're applying the oil as well as, again, giving some nice long strokes while we apply the oil. And here, what you can do is go underneath. I'm going under with my right hand and pulling up, then under with my left hand and up the neck, under with my right hand, pulling up. And I'm encouraging the curve of the neck too, pushing, letting my hand push up the neck a little bit so it feels a little better that way. I'm going all the way up the neck. So you're stroking as well as giving a nice little stretch because I'm leaning back, so it's giving a natural pull at the same time. Okay. And then come over the top of the shoulders, leaning into each shoulder, pushing down. And we can work each side of the shoulder with the thumbs, the top of the shoulders. Feel for those tight spots. And hold. These points are really nice just to give a few moments to hold them. Them to let go.
Okay.
Okay. It's always nice to stop on these points that are usually tight on most people, on the very top of the shoulders, and just hold them for a few moments. If you want, you can sit here for, you could hold these points for a couple minutes until you feel a pulsing if you want to do it that way. It can be really relaxing. Okay, so I'm just holding these points. This is right where it's really tight on most people. Not putting a lot of pressure. You can just let it, just hold it gently, and it really helps that muscle to let go. You can hold this up to a couple minutes and if you want. This helps. It's a very relaxing point to hold. It really relaxes the whole body. There we go. Work some more with the thumbs. So I'm working all along the muscles here on the top. Top and slightly to the back where they're tight. And you can just feel along the top, feeling, doing little circular movements along the back side of the top of the shoulders where they're tight. Just working all over the top of the shoulders, down to the top of the scapula there. And up the neck. Then, you can take the hand with one hand on one side. I'm gonna put a little bit more oil on it. Hand on one side, underneath, and the other hand on her head, I'm going to turn it to the side. I'm just going to turn it a little bit so that I can get the side of the neck. And you want it to stay down this side of the neck. You don't want to go over to the front. And here I'm also just naturally, because my hand's there, I'm also working with my fingertips on the other side of the neck. Because I'm just doing a squeezing motion here with my hands, so my fingers are going up at the same time, the other side of the neck. So you're really working both sides of the neck at the same time. Stroke and do the other side the same way. You can see how my fingers are working the other side of the neck at the same time. Then we can also, some people you can do this with and some it's harder. You can just feel if it works. You can take, by holding one hand under the neck, you can reach under with the other hand down between the spine and the shoulder blades. And once they're lifted, then you can get the other hand under the other side. Then you can work up with your fingertips. Doing okay?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Okay. I'm going to take one hand, I'm lifting, holding the neck, and with the other hand, reaching down my fingertips between the shoulder blade and the spine. And then once it's in, I can take the other hand, lift up a little bit, take the other hand. Now, some people that are really heavy, you just can't do this, but... And then I'm working with both hands, the fingertips, along that tight area that's so tight on most people, the rhomboids, between the shoulder blades and the spine on both sides. The circular movements. I'm slowly working my way up to the top. Do that again. Holding. Then you can reach down both sides. circular movements, working my way up and up the neck with the fingers. And then you can work up the neck, both sides of the spine with the fingertips, like so. Circular movements, slowly working your way up to the base of the skull. Reaching under, getting my hand under the head. I'm going to work along the muscles that attach to the base of the skull along the occipital ridge there. This is really an important area, another attachment point. By working these points, which are usually tight, just some circular movements with the fingertips. This can really help all the muscles of the neck to let go and can really help with headaches and neck tension. I'm just feeling with my fingers for tight areas on the muscles there, all along the edge of the skull, down underneath the bottom of the skull. And just work that till you feel it loosen up a little bit. Stroke up the neck again. We did at the beginning. And here at the end, you could do a real gentle little pull since we're underneath there. Let's go gentle pull. Down the shoulders and finish with a holding at the base of the skull. Okay. Mm-hmm. Just down each side of the spine like that. A little bit over the sacrum, out over the hips and back up. Complete. Finish with another effleurage, a couple of long strokes. Another warming up stroke, just a long stroke to warm up the muscles again a little bit more. A bigger stroke would be going up and down both sides like this. And here the main pressure is with my fingertips up between the shoulder blades and the spine on the rhomboids. Leaning into, because it's always a tight area up here on most people. And over the shoulders, back down.
How's the massage, Kate?
Mm-hmm. So good.
Oh, excellent.
Good.
When was the last time you had a massage?
1990.
Oh my God.
Oh my gosh.
I think it was like 2001 or something.
Oh my God. Mm-hmm. Oh, you're overdue.
Oh, this is so amazing, Lita.
Good.
I'm in love with you.
Wow.
I should keep that on the tape.
I'm just so grateful. This is so nice.
Can you get a long 2-hour massage? Go this way.
Oh God.
Yeah, it just gets the whole side and then gives you a good position to get up between the rhomboids, which you usually need extra attention on everybody, or on the rhomboids, between the shoulder blades and the spine, and a little bit over the shoulder, just finishing like that. And you can just go back and forth a little bit, where it's, if it's tight in the lower back, you could spend a little more time down here. Just feel. It also helps you to feel. These long strokes help give you a chance to feel where the tight areas are and where you're going to want to spend more time and attention to. Like she needs more attention up here. So. Okay. I didn't do it this one, so that's probably good too. It's very good. This stroke too, you can lean forward and start to use your forearm with it too. So, especially between the shoulder blades. Okay, and then we can start working down both sides of the spine. And here I'm using the whole thumb, so I'm working this whole muscle area on both sides of the spine and just leaning into it. The sacrum, and over the hips, and back up. Again. And you can vary it by going down one side at a time. And I'm staying off the spine, not putting weight on the spine with my hands or anything. I'm just focusing on the muscles on either side. Side. Circular, both sides at the same time. Back and forth. So you're working the attachments, the muscles, the small muscles to the spine. And that's always whenever you can work the attachments to the bones in the area where the muscle actually attaches to the bones, it really helps the muscles to let go. And relax. Okay, and always finishing with a long stroke. Smooth it all out. Okay, so with this one, I take her arm and give it a little rock with one hand. I'm just holding it here, so it's just helping it to let go. And then sitting on the table and putting it over my knee like that. And then I'm going to use this part of my arm to work up this side of her spine along the muscle. And this can be a really deep move, but so you want to be really careful. Check in with the client, not go too deep. I'm just putting a little bit of body weight into it. And check in with her. Does that feel like it's okay pressure?
Yes.
Okay. And go up between the shoulder blades, and the spine. And then you can just lean into it. Breathe. A little farther, lean again, breathe. A little farther down. You're always being careful to stay off the spine. And here I'm using this part of the arm, not the elbow. Back up again, lean into it, breathe. You don't want to use the sharp point of the elbow, it just would be uncomfortable. So when we're using the forearm, you always just use this part of your arm, it's a lot more comfortable. And here you want to be careful with your body mechanics too, that you're not overextending your shoulder, your own shoulder. You're not using too much pressure. And then you can give a little rock and go up. As I'm doing this, you can kind of feel for what depth works right. You can go a little bit deeper, just feeling in what feels right for your partner. You can also go down slowly. From this angle, you could turn a little bit and work on the lower back a little bit, too. So I'm mainly just working along these muscles here, along the spine again. And back up. And I feel like with her, the upper back is the tightest, so I'm getting more attention up there. And from this position, so you're here, you can also work a little bit more with your hands, with your fingers, putting the pressure in with your fingertips up between the shoulder blades here. It's a good position to work from. And you can work a little bit more on the shoulders. Here I'm using both hands with my body weight, so you can put a little bit more pressure. Down over the shoulder. Okay. Lift up, back. Sit back down. So I take my hand here and just kind of scoop it under like that. And pull it out. Get a little rock. And take my other hand and place it over my knee. Like that.
Your time.
No, no problem.
No. We appreciate your willingness to.
Oh, that's great.
Good. So let's see, what else is there on the back that we need to show? Trying to think of what else. Oh, this one on the shoulders. Okay. Ready for that one? Okay, now this one, again, we're going to use the forearms and my whole body weight for, or my body weight for leaning into it. And I need to get in the right position for this. You need to kind of put your feet apart and back a little bit so you can lean forward and then just go down between the shoulder, or between the spine and the shoulder blades. Actually, as I turn my arm, as I'm going down, it turns out I'm actually working this part of my arm, using that side of my arm. And the pressure totally comes from me just leaning into it. Really true with most all the strokes, rather than using my arms for weight, I just use my whole body weight. And then you can stop. Like here, it's especially tight, so I'm going to stop and lean into it a little bit. It's a little shiatsu move. Pressure work, just leaning down in, helps the tight muscles to let go. Encourage the client to breathe. Take out a deep breath. When I breathe, when I'm leaning into it, I take a deep breath and a deep breath and helps the client to do the same thing. Oh, you got the dog in the picture too. That's nice. Actually, I'm going to get nice.
He's not in it, but.
Oh, what a sweet touch.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, okay.
The dog and massage.
Yeah.
That's a whole other video.
Mm-hmm. You know, actually, that might be.
Just like phasing quickly to the picture of the dog is kind of cute somewhere in there because she's so relaxed.
Yeah.
Okay, so are we going to go again on that one?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, so this move, I'm going to use this part of my forearm, and we're going to work down between the shoulder blades, staying off the spine, just between the spine and the shoulder blades. And I'm back far enough so that I can just lean into this and go down one side. And again, this can be very deep, so you want to check in, make sure, feel what feels right for your client. When you feel a really tight spot like here, you can stop and just lean into it. Take a deep breath. And you're actually working a little bit on the top of the shoulders here too. Because as I come up, you can come up over the shoulders and down between the shoulder blades. Over and down. And a variation of that, to go even deeper, is you can pull the arm up and hold a little bit if it wants to slip off and go like this. This way you're lifting up the shoulder blade so you can get down in there a bit more. Again, you want to be really careful you don't go too deep. I'm working a little bit down between the shoulder blades, and a little more up between as I go down between, a bit more on top. And then when you finish, you can underneath and scoop underneath and give it a little rock and loosen it up a little bit. Go to the other side. I'm taking my hand here and going under the arm to hold it while I lift up with my other hand, holding it because some people's hands might want to slip off. And then with my other arm, I'm starting here on this part of my arm. I'm starting up at the top, so I'm getting a little bit of work on the top of the shoulders and down between the shoulder blades and the spine. And being very gentle because it's you can go very deep, very easily. Just by lifting up the shoulder blade like this, you can get down underneath and get those attachment points a little bit better. Again, staying off the spine. I'm pretty much leaning up a little bit against, in her case, against the scapula here a little bit. So I'm getting really down underneath. And when I'm done, it's nice to reach under like this and give it a little rock. And you can even give it a little shake and loosened up, make sure she's all loose and comfortable again. Okay. Voila. So here from this angle, we can just go some long strokes. So we start with some long strokes to just kind of warm those muscles up there and transition into a new area. This one, just this stroke is really nice. You could just, I'm leaning into it again. Feeling the tightness in the shoulders up there. Okay, and then go to one side. I'm just working down the top of the shoulder. Using both thumbs. Just long strokes down the muscles on the top. And as you find tight spots, you can stop and work them a little bit. Circular movements. Here I'm just putting pressure on the tight spot and giving a little circular rocking to help it to let go. Just down the muscle. Okay, so we're doing the isolated part. Is that what you want me to do, or just the whole thing here?
Start with the whole thing.
Okay. Top of the shoulder blade, or top of the shoulder. Feeling for tight spots. When you find a tight spot, you can stop and put a little pressure and just rock it, shake it. Circular movements. Just helping it to just let go, because these muscles tend to want to just hold on up here on the shoulders in most everybody. Back and forth. You can even go up a little bit over the top. Top of the shoulder blade there. Going down with one thumb, down with the other thumb, down between the shoulder blades, down the top of the shoulder. Always finishing with a long stroke. And go to the other side. And go to the other side. Feeling for tight areas. Tight areas. Here you can also be working a little bit with your fingers while you're doing it. It's just a natural thing because you feel natural to grip right there. So in the meantime, I'm also working down there a little bit, but focusing on up here, the top. You can go up the neck a little bit, down, down, top.
What is that point there that you've done?
These points on the top of the shoulders tend to get very tight on most everybody. So by just putting pressure when you find these points and just holding it, it helps them to just let go. And you can hold briefly, or you can hold longer. And there's shiatsu acupressure points. And we'll be working on those when we turn over a little bit more. And always finish off with the top of the shoulders. Long strokes. So we're going to do the whole back of the leg. We're going to start with long effleurage strokes again. Okay, so what I would say is use a good massage oil. You could use just almond oil or any kind of oil that doesn't have a strong scent, or you buy a good massage oil that you can buy. They have an ingredient in them. A lot of the new massage oils now are made so that they'll wash out of the sheets easily, so you don't have a buildup of oil in the sheets, and that's really good. You just want to make sure that you don't use oil that's rancid. You want to make sure it's fresh. So you might want to keep your massage oil in the refrigerator if you don't use it very often, and then maybe warm it up in a pan before you use it. So we're just doing long strokes to warm up the muscles in the back of the legs now, and also to oil the legs, get the oil on the legs, and just the long strokes are really relaxing too. So they're always important to just always, from one transition to the other, go do long strokes. And we're going to focus on the lower leg and do some back and forth kneading. Here I'm leaning down the top and also gripping a little bit from the side. So I'm working both the outer side as well as the top of the leg. You can go on up, and when you go over the knee, go really light. You don't want to put pressure on the back of the knee. Okay, and then we'll focus a little bit more on the lower leg, with our thumbs going up. And here it's good, I find, to use the whole thumb, not just isolate, because that can make you want to jump. So just go up with a whole thumbs, both sides, working up the center, the belly of the muscle. And again, I'm leaning into this, as always, just with my whole body. And you can go alternate, like this. And then go up lightly over the back of the knee, up the back, and down. Now, I'm going to take this hand and hold under here and lift up the leg like this. And from this position, we can take the ankle like this and lift up. So I'm bending down and lifting up a little bit so I don't strain my back and giving a little bit of rock. So now what we're going to do is take one hand under here, and with the other hand, lift the leg up like this, and grab at the ankles like this, bend down, lift up, straighten up, and lift the leg, knee off the table, and give it a little rock down, and rock the leg. This helps it to let go of the muscles. And then you can take the foot from this angle and twist, giving this ankle stretch both directions. And then I'm going to sit on the end of the table here and set the foot on my shoulder. And from this angle, you can work down the back of the leg, like so. You can do long strokes like this. You're like a draining stroke. You're always wanting to move in the direction of the heart, so the blood's moving in the direction of the heart. So you can go down like that, and then up the back of the leg like so. That's a good position for working the back of the leg. Alternating thumbs and leaning in with the palm of the hand all the way up to the hip. And back down. And you can do some long strokes down and up and down and up. You can also work the bottom of the foot a little bit from this angle. I'm pressing down with my fingertips and squeezing. So, and we're squeeze the heel. Okay. I'm gonna bring the leg down, like so, and then finish with a long stroke. Okay. Okay. So, some long strokes up the leg to get oil on the leg. And so. I'll start with this. Like this, on the top of the foot. Here I'm working along the top with my thumbs and also putting pressure with my fingers on the bottom. So you're working, kind of squeezing, working both sides down between the bones and the feet, metacarpals down the toe, down each toe.
Oh, I know that feels good. I love that one.
Yeah.
That right there. That's it.
And then with both hands, and I'm working the bottom of the foot at the same time with my fingers. And then another stroke like this. I'm working the inside of the heel with my thumbs. And working a little bit at the same time with the outside with my fingertips, just all around the heel. You work up Achilles tendon a little bit there. And then down the instep of the foot here is really important. Here I'm using my whole thumbs all the way down. And then from this angle, you can start to work the bottom of the foot. And I'm going to get down on my knees to work the bottom. And here you can work it's all along the foot with both thumbs, using circular movements. Here I'm working down the instep. In reflexology, this is along the spine, so this is a really important area. Down the middle of the foot. Top of the foot. Work all over around the toes. Both sides. Just getting all the area of the bottom of the foot. Down the heel. And do alternate pressing like this. And hold the ankle, give it a little stretch it. Nice stretch. Okay, and then finish it off with some long strokes again. Again, working the top and the bottom at the same time over the heel. And then we can go and work the leg. Up the leg. And here I'm working on both sides. The tibia bone up the calf. I'm working here with my finger and my thumb on the far side. Just kind of going up along the bone. And down. Along the edge of the bone, the side of the bone there. Not on the bone, on the muscle. Up and down. And you can do circular. Here I'm actually going up both sides of the calf. Going to work on the sides with the thumbs, going back and forth, alternating your way up. And you're also working the top at the same time with your hands, but focusing on the sides. And on the inside. Also do this move back and forth, ringing movement. Shake as you go down. Like that. There. So we do the whole arm here. You're oiling the arm first. Getting both sides. You oil on both sides of the arm. Okay, then we're going to start with a hand. Here. Work down between the bones, down to the fingertips. A little bit over the wrist. More down between the bones. And then we'll turn it over and work on the underside. We're interlacing the fingers like so, and then so like that, so we're like this. And then we're working the bottom of the hand. This feels wonderful. We can find, especially along the thumb, it's nice to work a little extra along there. You can work the points or just wherever you feel it's a little tight. Circular movements all over the bottom of the hand. And work around, and here I'm squeezing here along the thumb, the finger and the thumb, finger on the outside, the thumb on the inside here. Work on the top and the sides. You can get a little stretch. Okay. And turn over. Just give a general massage over the hand. And over the wrist. And then we'll start on the forearm. Okay, so we're going to go up the arm. Now that we've done the hands, we're going to go up the arm. Do long strokes to get the arm oiled and introduce yourself to the arm. Up both sides. And hold the hand with one hand, go up the arm with the other. Inside. And then we'll start on the forearm. You can hold with one hand and just work with the other one. Down the top of the forearm, often pretty sore on people. So you can also feel in the belly, the muscle again, for if it's especially tight, just feel for some tight spots and work them. And work some more all the way down to the elbow here in the front. Both sides. Then I'm going to turn the arm and work on the underside. Variation on this too, if you have an apron on and you're not worried about the oil, you can lean it up against your body or hand and work both at the same time. So here I'm working the inside of her arm with my thumbs and the back front of the arm, the top of the arm with my fingers. So you're squeezing and working the whole arm, forearm. You can also do it that way on the other side, leaning hand against your body. You can work both hands at the same time. Another variation is you can start here, leaning the hand up against your body just slightly and taking both hands like this. We're squeezing down the arm. It's like a draining move. Okay, then we'll go up the upper part of the arm. Just giving one last stroke over the whole arm before I move on to the upper part. And then I'm going to take the arm like so, holding it in my right hand, and walk over here. And I'm going to take it with my left hand, hold it like so, and let it fall down there. And from this position, we can work down the upper arm and go back and forth movement. You can go all the way down to the shoulder this way. I'm here. I'm putting pressure down on the with my thumbs and squeezing up with my hands. So you're working the whole arm at the same time, whole both sides of the upper arm. Okay, work the shoulder some more, holding the elbow up with one hand. You can lift it up a little bit on the shoulder. More back and forth. It is possible to do this without it leaning against your body. It just flops around a little bit more.